Hello everyone, I'm Jack Fisher and welcome to my world. And having followed the Marvel Cinematic Universe since its debut with the first Iron Man movie, I think most can agree it's been a hell of a ride. Coming out of that movie all those years ago, you never would have guessed it would have spawned such a vast cinematic universe. Having been a Marvel fan long before that movie ever came out, I feel like I've enjoyed the ride even more. Seeing the comics I've loved for years come to life like this, it's just hard to put into words the special kind of joy it has brought me. Following it all these years, it has been a remarkable experience, and I hope to keep following it for years to come. That being said, I don't deny the MCU is at an increasingly uncertain state. By that, I don't mean the production value or the quality of the stories are lacking. It's just that the success and scope of the MCU is so unprecedented that there's just no comparison or guide. Seriously, how does the MCU continue to grow, evolve, and expand? More importantly, how does it continue to succeed along the way, thrilling longtime fans while attracting new ones? These are important questions. They're also quite relevant for Disney shareholders and executives. Marvel Studios will be expected to keep succeeding, and how it goes about achieving that success remains to be seen. We do currently have a roadmap for future movies and shows, but that roadmap only goes so far, and it's getting to a point where the success of the past might actually become a liability for success in the future. So with that in mind, I want to make the case in this video that there is a way for Marvel Studios to move forward and continue succeeding. Not just for phases 5 and 6, but for many more phases into the future. And I'm also going to make the case that the best way to do this is to use Avengers Secret Wars, currently slated for May 2026, to initiate a soft reboot for the entire MCU. Why a reboot, and why a soft reboot at that? And why use Secret Wars to do it? Well, to explain, I'll need to provide some perspectives. Throughout the history of comics, reboots and relaunches have been fairly common. From DC Comics' famous Crisis event in the 1980s, to 2015's Secret Wars crossover event by Marvel, it's happened many times over the years. The nature of the stories may vary, but the intentions and effects are usually similar. They help wipe the slate clean, partially or in full, thereby paving the way for a new creative direction. The overall history and continuity of the comics isn't completely abandoned, it's just revised, tweaked, or reshaped, allowing for a new status quo to emerge. Now, that often happens in the comics when new writers, editors, and artists come aboard, and need more flexibility in telling their respective stories. For the Marvel Cinematic Universe, however, I think it has less to do with the story and more to do with logistics. Making movies, after all, is much more difficult than producing comics. You've got actors, studios, sets, scripts, producers, executives, and all the distribution mechanisms that go into it. That is a huge operation, and the cost of producing TV shows isn't cheap either. But beyond those challenges, many of the actors and actresses that helped forge the early days of the MCU have since moved on. Some have either walked away from their roles completely, others have just aged out of them. While Marvel Studios has done an admirable job bringing in new characters, as well as continuing the legacy of past characters, that approach can only go so far. Eventually, fans are going to want to see Captain America, Iron Man, Thor, Black Widow, Black Panther, and Spider-Man again. The legacy characters are nice and all, but there will always be a demand for the originals. That's just the nature of the fandom. It may seem difficult to contemplate recasting someone like Iron Man or T'Challa, but logistically, it's unavoidable if Marvel Studios wants to keep the MCU going. It's just a matter of setting it up in a way that audiences will accept. And from a narrative perspective, a reboot is the best way to go about it. However, I believe it needs to be a soft reboot in order to work. And yes, that distinction does matter a great deal. In recent years, reboots have gotten a bad reputation, and for good reason. more often than not, they are handled very poorly. And they rarely succeed in revitalizing a franchise or a story. When it comes to what form they take, that too can add some difficulty to the mix. Hard reboots are blunt and simple. They basically throw out the previous continuity completely and start fresh, often with new versions of the same characters and an entirely new creative direction. The 2017 Tom Cruise version of The Mummy was a reboot in that mold, basically abandoning the 90s era movie led by Brendan Fraser. The same goes for 2013's Man of Steel, which effectively abandoned the Superman continuity established by Richard Donner. Regardless of the success these efforts achieved, or lack thereof, they were able to more fully reinvent their respective franchises. They had a lot more flexibility to work with and weren't bound by the shackles of continuity. And while that might have offered benefits in some respects, it's still difficult to pull off because they're still always going to be compared to the originals. And just casting all that history and lore aside almost never sits well with fans. For that reason, among many others, this should not be Marvel Studios' approach with the MCU. Because by contrast, a soft reboot attempts to bridge the two narratives. It takes the continuity of a previous story, shakes it up in a major way, and cleans some, but not all, of the proverbial slate. The events of the past still happened, and they still matter a great deal. But certain events and structures are done away with, thereby allowing for a new narrative to take hold. That's the approach taken by Jurassic World in 2015, which acted as a soft reboot for the Jurassic Park franchise. The same thing happened with Star Trek in 2009. The past continuity wasn't abandoned completely, it was just reshaped and reconfigured within a story. And this is something the Marvel Cinematic Universe is already set up to do, thanks to the introduction of the multiverse. It was set up initially in the first Doctor Strange movie, but has since been expanded greatly upon by Multiverse of Madness, No Way Home, and Loki. That expansion is likely to continue with Deadpool 3, Ant-Man Quantumania, and the Kang Dynasty. We can already see the signs of an eventual multiverse culmination with Secret Wars. That doesn't mean it has to end in a reboot, but the foundation is there, and I believe Marvel Studios should build upon it. This way, the reboot feels organic and unforced. It also would fit perfectly into the story that has been unfolding throughout multiple movies and TV shows. And by being a soft reboot, it can retain the elements of past phases that fans still hold in such high regard. It really would be the best of both worlds, relatively speaking. Even if a soft reboot makes the most sense, even if the Marvel Cinematic Universe is already set up to make it happen, there's still one important element to consider. And it's probably the most important element of all. The story. Just doing a reboot of any kind for the sake of doing it, that's not a good reason. It's not even an understandable reason. It's just plain lazy writing. But if reboot is a functional aspect of a larger story, and if that story has compelling themes and relevant insights, then it's no longer the main point. It's the narrative catalyst to something much bigger. Like I said earlier, Marvel Studios has been laying the foundation with the multiverse saga. We've already seen multiple timelines intermingle. We've seen multiple versions of beloved characters cross over and interact. We've also seen conflicts emerge within the multiverse, the kind that cannot and should not be ignored within the MCU's overarching narrative. It's just a matter of weaving those various elements together into a cohesive story. And I say that's certainly a story worth telling, not just because it could lead to a soft reboot. Since the first Avengers movie, we've seen more and more characters tap into new types of power, be they the Infinity Stones, Super Soldier formulas, time travel, reality warping spells, the Celestials, or Pym Particles. The stakes just keep on rising. And they're going to continue rising, especially with Kang the Conqueror entering the picture. Whether it's by the heroes themselves or their enemies, there are always larger consequences to every act. Vision himself points this out in Avengers: Age of Ultron. The sheer power of the Avengers invites increasingly powerful opponents. So the stakes just keep escalating and escalating. So how much further can they go? How many times can the fate of the world be threatened? At some point, the consequences have to manifest for the villains, the heroes, and the countless innocent lives they try to protect. The emergence of the multiverse has introduced a lot of chaos into the MCU, and adding Kang's time travel tactics is sure to add to it even more. At some point, someone or something has to temper that chaos. That is likely the endgame for this current phase of the MCU. While a soft reboot might not be the end result of such a story, it's still a story worth telling. But it's the aftermath of that story that might be more impactful in the long run. Avengers Endgame was a massive culmination for an incredible story that spanned multiple movies over the course of a decade. What began with the events of the first Iron Man movie ultimately came together in a major way by the end of Endgame. And it was nothing short of an incredible cinematic experience for which there was no precedent. Neither Star Wars nor Harry Potter ever came close to achieving this level of narrative scope or scale. But Avengers Secret Wars promises to be even bigger than that. It's not hyperbole to say that it might just end up being the biggest cinematic event in the history of entertainment. But regardless of how much hype there is for this movie, its lasting legacy will be how it ends, as well as where the MCU will go from there. Now, I certainly won't claim that it has to end with a soft reboot. It's entirely possible that Marvel Studios has another endgame in mind, one that's probably much better than anything I could come up with. But if the Marvel Cinematic Universe is going to reboot itself in any form, Secret Wars offers the best possible opportunity. And that's not just because of how the story has been set up by the multiverse saga. Reshaping the entire continuity is also something that's very much in keeping with the source material, namely the Secret Wars comics. Now, to be clear, Marvel has published an event called Secret Wars on multiple occasions. Once in 1984, and again in 2015. While the background and outcome of each story was different, the setup was still similar. The Marvel Universe as we knew it at the time was broken. Once by the hands of the Beyonder, and again by the results of one too many universal incursions. And in both cases, the multiverse was forcibly stitched back together. In the process, it was forever altered, and it was up to Marvel's greatest heroes to rebuild a shattered universe. But doing so came at a price, and if Marvel Studios stays true to those themes, then a soft reboot could very well be part of that price. In the comics, something had to be lost in order to save everything and everyone. But in doing so, something far greater was gained in the long run. The end of 2015 Secret Wars perfectly demonstrated that. And I highly recommend everyone to check that comic out, along with the 1984 story. But it's that latter element, gaining something greater in the long run through sacrifice of something from the past, that I feel is most critical. It's a core element of the Secret Wars story as a whole, and it's a story uniquely conducive to fostering a reboot, be it in part or in full. But beyond simply clearing the slate for the future of the MCU, a soft reboot through Secret Wars would have other benefits in the long run. Back when Disney acquired Fox, Marvel Studios announced that the X-Men and the Fantastic Four were coming to the MCU. And since then, they've already shown up in some capacity, with Reed Richards and Charles Xavier showing up in Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. And there's certainly more to come with Deadpool 3 set to come out in 2024, a full 2 years before Secret Wars, no less. So the movie rights issues for those two franchises have been resolved. But even with these characters back under Disney's control, the question still remains. How does Marvel Studios go about incorporating them into the current Marvel Cinematic Universe? Now, I've already made multiple videos about this challenge. I've even proposed my own theory about how to go about it. But at the moment, we really don't know what Marvel Studios has planned for the Fantastic Four or the X-Men. We just know that a Fantastic Four movie has been confirmed, and after the events of Ms. Marvel, mutants are officially a thing in the MCU. But incorporating these massive franchises into an already crowded cinematic universe, it's going to be an undeniable challenge, both logistically and from a storytelling perspective. Now, explaining the absence of the Fantastic Four wouldn't be that difficult, but explaining the absence of the X-Men and the entire mutant race, that would present more than a minor plot hole. Now, it's entirely likely that Marvel Studios already has a plan for that, and it's a plan nobody outside Kevin Feige's inner circle knows about. But a soft reboot through Secret Wars offers another opportunity to bring mutants, the X-Men, and that entire uncanny world into the MCU in an organic way. Currently, the biggest challenge from a narrative perspective involves explaining where all the mutants have been all this time, as well as why they haven't been mentioned or assisted in any major conflicts or battles thus far. Yes, the movie rights was the logistical reason for their absence, but a narrative reason is still necessary. Out of legal necessity, the MCU was a Marvel universe devoid of mutants. It has grown, expanded, and evolved without them or the Fantastic Four. So for mutants to just show up randomly, that wouldn't make a lot of sense. Not without the same multiverse machinations that we saw in Multiverse of Madness. But it's the precedent of that same movie, and possibly whatever Deadpool 3 ends up doing, that might ultimately set the stage for telling that story. And I think it's quite revealing that, other than Deadpool 3, there was no mention of any X-Men projects announced before Secret Wars. I think it's just as telling that Marvel Studios is bringing Hugh Jackman back to play Wolverine once more, even though he's close to aging out of that role. If they want to use Secret Wars as a means of blending the events of the MCU with another timeline populated by mutants, well, the setup is there. And the aftermath could leave it so we have an entirely new world, one that has the Avengers, the X-Men, the Fantastic Four, and every other franchise. It wouldn't just be a culmination of all the events that have been unfolding since the beginning of Phase 4. Secret Wars would feel like a homecoming of sorts. The end of the story on how the Marvel Universe became whole again. The worlds of the Avengers, the X-Men, and the Fantastic Four finally becoming one. It would require a new level of world building. But for Marvel fans of multiple generations, it would make for an incredible moment. A true manifestation of all the characters they love finally uniting within the same world. Beyond just being a beautiful ending to such a vast story, it could also set the stage for an even more promising future. A big part of what has made the Marvel Cinematic Universe so successful is how it's set up for the long term. Every movie and show builds on the same foundation, weaving and intertwining various characters and stories together in a compelling way, all while crafting an elaborate cinematic spectacle. From Iron Man to Thor to Captain America to Spider-Man to Captain Marvel, there's always a bigger picture and a larger plan in place. And while not every part of that plan has been executed flawlessly, there's still a plan. And it's always looking ahead, preparing for bigger and bolder stories. After over a decade of movies and shows, that plan has grown a great deal. And by the time Secret Wars comes out in 2026, it will have encompassed an entire generation of fans. Whatever the plan may be for phases beyond Secret Wars, Marvel Studios and their Disney overlords need to keep looking ahead. A soft reboot would help by providing a critical turning point. A moment in time where the MCU took a step from being one thing and moved forward to becoming something else. It would present an opportunity to not just create a cinematic universe with the X-Men and the Fantastic Four, it would also offer a world in which new versions of Steve Rogers, Tony Stark, Natasha Romanoff, and Peter Parker could emerge. Some characters may still retain the memories and experiences of the universe that was. Events from before Secret Wars would still matter a great deal, and still impact events in both the future and the present. And those sorts of details are vital to making any soft reboot work. That way, the MCU isn't starting from scratch, but it isn't entirely beholden to the baggage of the past either. Now, nobody outside Marvel Studios knows what the future holds for the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And we probably won't know until Secret Wars is finally released in theaters. Regardless of whether or not it ends in a reboot, hard or soft, there's no doubt it'll be a hell of a spectacle. I believe that, for the continued long-term success of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, a major transition of some kind is necessary. One that'll allow this universe to grow and evolve in new ways. It need not rebuild from scratch, but like every ongoing story, it'll have to reimagine, reinvent, and refine itself. I strongly believe that Marvel Studios has more great stories to tell and more great cinematic spectacles to share. And Secret Wars, if done right, will help set it up to astonish a new generation of fans. That way, no matter who wins the war, we the fans will ultimately come out on top. Thanks for watching, everyone, and thanks for joining me in my world. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and until next time, take care and stay safe.